zazingu 2006 uba ndi HIV positive. Then ndavila kabuhlungu. Ndava kabuhlungu but ndayamkela ekugqibeleni ba andizoyithini. Andizoyilahla ba yeyam.
With 5 million people estimated to be HIV positive, South Africa has the largest number of people living with HIV in the world. The township of Khayelitsha, just outside Cape Town, is one of the areas most affected by HIV, with 20% of its 500,000 adult residents living with the virus. Here, HIV treatment scale-up has been exponential, and by August 2012, 24,000 people were receiving ART. As the number of people on treatment increases, so does the proportion of people being lost to care as clinics become saturated. For patients like Bonyo Futuza, whose livelihood relies on her informal job as a clothes trader, losing a day's earning in order to get her antiretroviral treatment is not an option. Every 2 months, Mongiwa attends an ART Adherence Club at the local library in Khayelitsha. The club session starts at 8 in the morning and lasts just over an hour, which allows patients to quickly resume their daily tasks. With the guidance of a lay facilitator, club members go through a quick clinical checkup, a peer discussion, and receive pre-packed ART. Patients reporting symptoms or weight loss are referred back to the clinic for assessment by a nurse. All club patients attend the clinic twice a year, once for blood taking and 2 months later for their annual clinical checkup. The ART Adherence Club model was piloted by Médecins Sans Frontières, or MSF, in Khayelitsha in November 2007. The model is helping decongest primary health care facilities by managing stable ART patients in non-clinical settings. It also enables clinicians to spend more time with new ART patients and those who are unwell or at risk of failing their treatment. With the support of the Western Cape Department of Health, City Health, and the Institute for Healthcare Improvement, the clubs have been rolled out throughout the Cape Metro. In Khayelitsha, there are now 180 clubs across 9 facilities, which amounts to roughly 19% of the 23,000 patients retained in care in Khayelitsha alone. MSF's analysis of the ART Adherence Clubs initially hosted at Ubuntu found that retention in care was 97% in the clubs as opposed to 85% of patients who qualified for clubs but stayed in mainstream clinical care. In addition, patients in clubs are 67% less likely to develop virological rebound. This means that they are not only more likely to stay in care but also more adherent to their treatment. Since May this year, MSF is also piloting community ART clubs in patients' homes.
Clubs are a long-term retention in care strategy, and MSF believes that we need to roll these out throughout South Africa and similar models in the rest of Sub-Saharan Africa to make sure that we can get all the people on treatment that we need on treatment and retain them in care.
However, for clubs to be rolled out by departments of health, appropriate resource planning is required. Club facilitator posts need to be funded. The burden of pre-packing ARVs on pharmacy staff needs to be relieved by using fixed-dose combinations and either appointing additional pharmacy assistants or using a central dispensing service.
MSF would like to see all stable, adherent ART patients who choose to do so being able to receive their treatment every 3 months around the corner from their home through a community ART club. This will allow our patients to stay on treatment for the rest of their lives.
Oh, ndicinga iclub eyona ndlela kuku ibhetere bekunosetyenzwa ngayo for wonke umuntu ophila nesifo sikagawulayo. Alendu ke ange a join iclub because club isebenza better kakhulu kuneclinic. So ndicebisa wonke umuntu ophila nesifo sikagawulayo angacingi uba ubomi buphelile, ayazi ubomi uyaqhubekeka.